Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I thought it would be the perfect time to share some holiday hairstyles since the holidays are coming up soon. And in today's video, I'll be using Aistee's Dual Heater Flatiron. This is a premium cordless hair straightener and would be the perfect gift for that favorite beauty guru that you have in your life. Whether you like your hair smooth and straight or with bouncy curls or as a chic updo, let me know in the comment section which of the three hairstyles is your favorite. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell, and let's get started. Before using the flat iron, I charged it using the cradle. Then I went ahead and sprayed my hair with a heat protectant spray and divided it into sections, clipping away the top hair. Once I was ready to use the flat iron, I held down the power button for 2 seconds and then selected the proper heat temperature setting. I set mine at 285, and the temperature settings are so precise that the hair is never overheated or burned. So I'm taking small sections between 1 and 2 inches and running the iron through the hair. And I'm just going to do all of the hair that I left down in this first section. Then once all of the hair is straightened, I'm going to take down the top section, mist it with the heat protectant spray, and then brush through it. I'm going to continue dividing off sections, clamping the iron over the sections, and then sliding it down the section of hair. One feature I really like is that the controls are tucked between the middle of the two handles, so I never accidentally turn it off or change the heat setting while I'm using it. So then I'm going to let down the last section of hair, and continue running the iron over small sections until it's all straightened. And if a section isn't straight enough after one pass, I simply divided out some hair and then went over it again at a slower speed. And since this flat iron has dual heater plates, it styles my hair a lot faster, meaning it causes less damage to my hair. For the second hairstyle, I'm going to be creating bouncy curls. Using the straightener, I'm going to place the iron upside down and clamp it over a 1-inch section of hair. Then I'm going to twist the iron towards the back of my head and slide it down the section of hair. This flat iron makes it so easy to curl my hair. The free moving plates are a great size for styling and they hold my hair tightly. My hair never snags in the plates, and since it also has a hidden hinge at the bottom end, my hair doesn't ever get caught and torn out. So I'm going to continue dividing off sections of hair, curling each one towards the back of my head. And for each section, I'm clamping the iron upside down with the handle pointing upwards. Then I'm going to twist the iron towards the back of my head and then slide it down the section of hair, twisting it as it goes down to the bottom of the section. And I'm just repeating the same steps with the hair on both sides of my head. Along with being a cordless flat iron, it also has a hybrid mode, so you can use a cord. And this means the iron can work while it's plugged in, so it uses the power from an outlet rather than its battery. But then once all of my hair is curled, I like to simply run my fingers through it, and this will help break up the curls. For the last hairstyle, I'm going to begin by parting my hair in a deep side part on the right side. Then I'm going to divide off a section of hair from the part line down to my left ear, clipping away the back section of hair. I'm going to use the flat iron to curl this hair, and since I'm doing an old Hollywood type of wave, I want to curl this section going forwards towards my face. So I'm dividing off small sections of hair, and I'm going to clamp the iron over this section so the handle is pointed upwards. Then I'm going to twist the iron towards my face a couple times before sliding the iron downwards towards the ends of my hair. So I'm going to continue dividing out small slices of hair and using the flat iron to curl each section towards my face. This will make pinning this section a lot easier at the end. So once this hair is curled, I'm going to create the bun portion of the hairstyle. So I'm going to take the remaining hair and tie it all together near the nape of my neck, slightly off-center towards the left side. Then I'm going to take the ponytail and divide it into 2 equal sections. With one section, I'm going to wrap this around the hairband a couple times to begin creating the bun. Then using bobby pins, I'm going to pin down this wrapped section until it feels secured in place and won't fall loose. Then I'm going to take the ends from the wrapped piece and create a loop, pinning it next to the bun with a few more bobby pins. And now with the other section of hair, I'm going to loop this up to the bottom of the bun on the left side and pin it in place with a couple bobby pins. Then I'm going to take the ends and loop these up to the bottom of the bun on the right side, securing it in place with a few more bobby pins. Now that's all done, I'm going to pin down the front section of hair that I curled at the beginning. So I'm going to first brush through this section and mist it with hairspray to smooth down any flyaways. Then I'm going to work with the curve of the hair and slide in clips wherever the hair creates a bend. So I'm placing my first clip just above my left temple. I like to call this the corner of my forehead. And I'm placing in this pin going towards the back of my head. And then I'm going to carefully brush through the hair again and then bend the hair slightly forwards, following the shape of the curl, and then curving it back again towards the bun. I'm going to place a second clip over the wave, just above my left ear, so it's going in towards my face. Then I'm going to continue curving the hair over my ear, back towards the bun, and I'm going to wiggle a bobby pin underneath this section of hair so it helps hold the section in place without showing. And then I'm going to take the first clip and place this over the bend behind my ear to help it keep its shape. And I'm also going to carefully slide some bobby pins into the other two bends in the hair just to help these stay a little bit more secure. And then I'm going to take the ends that are still remaining and I'm going to roll these up underneath the bun and then just pin them in place with another bobby pin. Make sure to check out Aisti's Dual Heater Premium Cordless Flat Iron. It's a great gift for that favorite beauty guru that you have in your life. I will make sure to link all of the information down below in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comment section which of the three hairstyles was your favorite, and a big thank you to Aisti for sponsoring today's video. Make sure to check them out. I will link all of the information down below in the description box. This would make the perfect gift for that favorite beauty guru that you have in your life. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos, and I will see you next time.